times of stress, it is natural and expected and easy that people will focus all their attention on managing the pressure and the stress, managing the trauma, managing this difficult reality. So it's mainly, you know, firefighting until the fire is off with minimum damage to you and to your surrounding. And that's natural. That's an automatic, reflexive, instinctive behavior so that we stay alive. Now, this is done at a human or individual level. It's also done, as you know, at a group level, at a family level, at an organization level, departmental level, community, society level, country level. It's a natural human behavior. Now, I'm going to take it a step further. Surviving in these difficult situations is an act of heroism, and it should not be taken for granted. When you go through tough times, when your family, your organization, your department goes through tough times, just making it to the end, you know, coming out of this mega storm of change of reality, this earthquake, tsunami that hit you, and everything that you stand on, you know, your entire life has been shaken. Coming out of that safe and secure and sound alone is an act of heroism, and it requires a huge amount of leadership. However, if you want to take your leadership to a next level, if you can do that, and some people can, and if you can't, it's also understandable because all relative to the amount of, you know, challenge you're facing. But if you can, work on two fronts. Number one, do whatever it takes so that you adapt and survive. And at the same time, keep an eye open for opportunities. Then, I'm telling you, you're going to make leaps. Because what you can expect from everybody else around you is to be stuck in, not stuck really, engaged in just the survival battle. And that's an honorable thing to do. It's normal. So everybody will just manage to survive. Now, if you can, through the strength of your character, the level of your consciousness, the level of your skills that you have, if you can, while doing that, also spot opportunities that emerge out of this new reality and position yourself and your team and your group and organization in a way that captures this, you're going to, I'm telling you, when this is over, you're going to be ahead of your competitors or people around you, you know, by maybe years. Of course, metaphorically I'm speaking. Why? Because while others were busy survival, you were picking up opportunities. And trust me, there are always opportunities. Always. Now, let's take a volcano or an earthquake. Of course, when a volcano or an earthquake happens, destruction happens, and it's a major change in the environment. But guess what? Sometimes out of volcano, you discover, I don't know, new kinds of minerals or raw material, or islands emerge in the ocean. Sometimes islands emerge out of, you know, in underwater volcanoes. So I'm using this as a metaphor so that you can not be, you know, not be confined to a survival perspective, but to a growth and opportunity hunting perspective. Let's take an earthquake. You know how many times treasures and caves and you know, valuable stuff were discovered after an earthquake? Because earth moved and cracks happened, and things were that were have been hiding under, you know, meters and piles of earth for a long time, now they came to the surface. Of course, I'm using all of this as a metaphor. My point is, there are always opportunities, especially in changing time. If you can move yourself from a panic or an adaptation mindset, right, into also a hunting mindset, an observing mindset, a curiosity mindset, an explorative mindset, where you're looking for opportunities, then it could be, you know, whatever other people say, see as a catastrophe or as, you know, as a major shake-up in reality or a disaster, for you, maybe this could have been the opportunity of a lifetime. But this requires, as I said, you know, strength, resilience, be in control of your emotions, not panic, self-confidence, a high level of consciousness, entrepreneurial mindset, faith in yourself, calm-headed mentality, so that, you know, you're using your mind to survive, but you're also in a quiet way, you're just observing in a neutral way and with a fresh eye. If you're in leadership position, if you are, you know, if you are in charge of organizations or countries or any kind of entities, keep this in mind. Look around you. You'll never know. It might be the opportunity of your lifetime.